Hey, what's up YouTubers? Welcome to Matt's Macintosh. What I have for you guys today is actually my most requested review, and this is a new review of my graphics tablet. Now, the one that I have is made by Wacom. Some of you guys might be familiar with their Bamboo series. It's kind of like their entry-level tablets. I actually have an Intuos, and the reason I haven't done a review of this already is that I actually have an older model. I have the Intuos 3. The Intuos 4 is the newest one that's out right now. You know, it's got a little sleeker design, some more functionality to it. But I got another email this week asking for a review of my tablet, so you guys demanded it. I'm not going to let you down. I'm going to deliver. Intuos 3 review. Let's do this.
Alright guys, well, some of you might remember from my laptop stand review. That's where I actually keep my tablet underneath the laptop. It's pretty good because, I mean, these tablets are fairly large and take up a lot of space on your desk. Now, looking at what actually comes in the box, you get a mouse, the stylus or the pen, a holder for it, and then, of course, the tablet itself. Looking at the tablet, you get customizable buttons on the side that you can kind of program to do what you want to do, as well as two touchpads that allow you to zoom in and out or scroll, whatever you have it programmed to do. Then on the pen itself, you get two buttons as well that essentially allow you to like right-click with it. All right, let's go ahead and move on to what everyone wants to see, and that's the actual tablet in action. So you can see here just a silly little robot picture that I made. I'll go ahead and add in a little helicopter attacking them. And one of the cool things about this is that it's pressure sensitive, so it actually feels fairly natural. Just like a real pencil, you can kind of just press down lightly and it'll make the lighter lines. And then when you mash down harder, it makes the more finished, darker lines. It's also tilt sensitive, which allows you to do kind of shading with it, just as a regular pencil would. And as I mentioned, those buttons on the side of the pen, when you actually press those down in Photoshop, you can get the controls, so you can go ahead and change the thickness. And then here you can really see the pressure sensitivity in action as I mash down lightly, and then harder, it makes like, you know, that more bold looking line. Now, something that's really awesome is that when you flip the pen upside down, it actually automatically switches to your eraser tool. So it really acts just like a regular pencil. So you'll really be able to make the transition from using physical paper and pen to using a digital tablet in no time. Bottom line, guys, if you're into any kind of digital art, design, cartooning, you really have to get a tablet like this. I can't stress enough how easy it's going to be for you to do digital work, and then what a great improvement you're going to see in your digital art as well when you own one of these. Now, there is one big reason to go for an Intuos 3 over an Intuos 4, and it's price. I mean, if you look at what the Intuos 3 is right now on Amazon, it's $200. Compare that to the Intuos 4, which is $315 even with the discount. So if you're willing to sacrifice a little bit of design and some of the more advanced features you get with the newer tablet, I highly recommend just getting the Intuos 3 and saving yourself some money. Final verdict, guys, I can definitely recommend the Intuos series with confidence to all you aspiring designers and artists that are out there. That's all I got for this video, guys. Like always, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you next time.